I'm a Biden supporter and I start Googling stuff about Biden, it's going to take me down a hole that's going to represent him the way I perceive it is. If I'm a Trump supporter, it's going to take me down that direction. If I'm looking at pornography, it's taking me down that direction. You should see the amount of ads I get for golf equipment.
I believe that. You're getting a world of golf equipment.
Right. And golf tips, golf coaches, golf tidbits. Everything I get is golf related. That's my bias.
The other one I love that you get is America's Got Talent. I'm like, you get this stuff on your Facebook feed because you've liked it once or twice before. So it's the idea of those that come out of obscurity to share a talent and come to claim and fame. What you're not seeing is
the failures. Right.
The failures. So you're seeing this track of you could gain this perception of, oh, if I just went out there and threw myself at the world, I'm going to be loved and be successful.
That's one way you could look at it.
Yeah, it's one way to look
at it. And the other way you could look at that is you're going, this is neat that this 15-year-old who has holes in his boots, doesn't have enough money to buy his own boots, one of the judges gave him his boots and he got a free ticket to L.A. to compete.
But the other thing is that you're perceiving that that's truth. And this is where we're getting away from why we want to use primary questions, because what you're perceiving through social media isn't always truth. It's a perception.
That's very well said.
And you don't really know what's being put on a stage, and your social media is nothing more than a stage.
Right. And it's going to help us. It will feed into our cognitive distortions because now who is right trumps what is right. And that just eliminated principle and eliminated primary questions.
Yeah. So you can just see when we talk about perceptions or in a relationship of why did that person do that? Well, that was offensive. That it is nothing more than what the way our brains receive information.
Political correctness. That's right. Just a great example.
Okay, so put this into a marriage. A husband and wife are facing severe marital challenge.
Well, I'm not finished there yet. You just give me one second.
I want to go there.
I know you do. I just want to finish and you summarized it, but I want to read what I wrote here. It's just, once someone starts down the road of secondary questions, they get stuck in the immaculate perception that everyone thinks like they do. They become obsessed with being right. And those who don't agree with them are uneducated radicals who need to be silenced and controlled. I just wanted to summarize that because that's, in effect, the political arena in which we exist.
Not only the political arena, it is when we double down on anything, that's what it looks like.
And now, beautiful segue into the husband and wife.
Right. So the wife explains the dire situation as follows. My husband always, notice the absolute, whenever we're telling ourselves something that it always happens, red flag, you got a problem. My husband always makes bad decisions. He needs a better job. He won't listen to me. And when I try to get him to see reason, he just clams up.
So the secondary question she's asking is
like, what's wrong with my husband? He needs to be fixed. Who can fix him?
So I got a phone call last week, a couple parents wanting to talk to me about their 15-year-old son. He's allegedly addicted to gaming. He has distanced himself from the parents, and they're really concerned. And these are great parents. I'm not disparaging them. They want the professional guidance to fix the son. In such situations, however, it's rarely the child who needs the guidance. Secondary questions never bear satiable fruit. What if, and this is a what if for both the parents and what if for the wife in this particular case. What if secondary questions such as, what's wrong with my son? Can you fix my son? What's wrong with my husband? Can you fix my husband? Were replaced with the primary one such as, how can I improve my relationship with my spouse or my child? In other words, what must I do?
And so our tagline of our show, you're 100% responsible for your happiness, joy, and well-being. Not for the happiness, joy, and well-being of your spouse or your game-addicted son.
So our ability to forge through difficult times or personal challenges is significantly impacted by the degree we each understand primary questions. In times of hardship, knowing there's a God who is our Father in heaven, a Redeemer who is Jesus Christ, and that we are each a child of God can remove suffering.
Mm-hmm.
It can diminish pain, and it can offer each of us the ability to perceive every experience that we have is perfect. It's exactly what we need at that time to integrate, to come closer to the divine, and to find happiness, joy, and well-being. So let's wrap this up now. This is four segments on it, and I want to answer the questions that God gave to Moses. He said, how can I make sense of this?
You mean Moses to God.
Yeah, did I say that wrong?
Yeah, he said God to Moses. But what Moses, so let's go back a couple segments ago that Moses observed these travelers. The first traveler came and left a purse. Second traveler found the purse and left. And third traveler came and fell asleep. First traveler came back and killed him.
Good.
Out of anger.
Right.
Thinking he was the one that took
his
purse.
You blamed him for it, right?
Yeah. You took my money.
Moses said, I fail to understand the ways of providence. I fail to understand the workings of divine justice. He doesn't question that he exists. He just doesn't understand them. Just tell me. What is going on here so I can understand? That was Moses' question.
Okay. And that whole scenario looks so confusing to him that something like that could happen. We have things that happen. COVID alone is confusing to the world, and we don't know why. Okay.
Here's God's answer. So he basically said, the man who lost the money, that's the number one traveler, had inherited it from his father, who had stolen it from the father of the man who found it. So now that one, number one and number two, they've been corrected. The man who had been killed, number three, had in years past killed the brother of the man who had killed him during the quarrel. So now that was taken care of. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, know then, O Moses, that I ordained it, that the murderer should be put to death by the brother of the victim, whilst the son should find the money of which his father had once been robbed. My ways are inscrutable, and often the human mind wonders why the innocent suffer and the wicked prosper.
So it sounds a little bit fatalistic when we describe, because this was apocryphal Hebrew tradition.
It's a legend.
It's a legend. It's not even scripture. But it sounds a little fatalistic. The point, the takeaway is that we don't always understand, and therefore we ask primary
questions. Otherwise, we'll be myopic in the story. We'll fail to get it. If we understand, for example, if I know that there's a God, or I believe I know that there's a God, I can live with a lot of stuff going on. Including COVID. I disagree with much of what that has been done in COVID. I disagree with much that is going on politically. I disagree with things everywhere.
It could be, I disagree with the way my wife cooks something, or the way that my wife does the laundry. It could be anything.
But it doesn't mean I have to be in resistance to it. I can disagree and still be in acceptance. I can still be happy. I can still live my life the best I can. I can learn from the things that don't go right. That doesn't change the fact that I am responsible for my happiness, joy, and well-being. If you become adept at recognizing first secondary questions for what they are, secondary questions, if you realize when people are waxing eloquent, they have to be right. They're addicted to being right. They're in contention, a who is right basis, not conflict, a what is right basis.
Yeah, I love it because there's a whole lot of stuff out there we don't have to sweat about as much because we recognize it for what it is.
Thank you so much for listening. We really appreciate it. We look forward to sharing more with you in the next segment. So stand by. We'll be back.
Inside my head. turn it down, but I can't quite drown it out. I'm tortured every day.